Welcome back to the Buckeye State Wales. Today is September 24th, 2022. We're out in Fostoria to be at the Railfest and the train show. Whoever we're going to meet, there's going to be a lot of people at the train show and at the Rail Park. The first train is I-131, heading southbound to Salem, Illinois, with Union Pacific, CN, and KCS Power. This is Google Earth, where Fostoria Iron Triangle is virtually at. It's kinda in the middle of Fostoria, Ohio. Well, at night, it's pretty bad for night rail fans sometimes. This is a westbound on the NS, Fostoria District, NS-277, with the Erie Heritage Unit heading towards Chicago, Illinois. The Erie Heritage Unit is nice to see again, but I always see all 20 of the Heritage Units.
got something boring to do.
That's
my first train on the Willow subdivision, which is I-165. I-165 usually goes by Fostoria OH nighttime, but I guess it was very late, so it had to go through this morning. Some CSX Eastbound manifest was heading eastbound on the weather sub. Had a restricted signal, but there's just still going to go by.
those moves, you should leave it right back down. We're going by far.
I don't know what this symbol is, but a BNSF grain train on the CSX Willard sub division is heading eastbound through Fostoria, Ohio. As I said, I don't know what the symbol is. This is one of the Y3C's website unit leading the grain train. train is the Norfolk Southern Eastbound Intermodal was on the Fostoria District in Fostoria, Ohio. Room. We just came from the sales. For HO scale. Woohoo! 1225!
I guess they blew a couple of flues out of it.
There's 161. That's like a 50th anniversary now.
Let's go over there. That's
yeah.
When you want your rack train to look like.
Chesapeake in Ohio. Way out. And this is what type of train that CSX train is going to run.
Fine.
Yeah, it is. extremely long. We're back at the tracks on the weather club on Poplar Street. We would see a CSX Eastbound comes along. We would be back at the tracks seeing no signals would be lit for a train. But after like probably some time we see like signals lit to a event approach, and now here comes the train. I-166 clear Fostoria with a P5 and a nice horn show from the crew. I-151 clear Fostoria, Ohio with a pair of BNSF. Was heading south on the Pemberville sub and now heading west, taking the Y to North Baltimore, Ohio to the Intermodal Yard in North Baltimore. Yeah.
like a worse bump around here.
Oh my god, let's touch this bump car! Touching the train! Let's touch the train, Dorothy!
Elliot, you need to realize something.
Hey, NS isn't clear though.
Elliot, this is how men have fun. Oh. You need to realize that.
NS isn't
good. Yeah, they just have a medium attack of both. Another eastbound with another intermodal. We intermodals in the world. Wow, that's kind of cool. Maybe kind of cool. But anyway, IO-10 clear Fostoria, Ohio on the Windows subdivision. Westbound on the weather sub, taking the Y from the Pumpernickel subdivision to the weather subdivision, heading west to Middletown, Ohio.
That's pretty noisy.
L-70 was heading back to Fostoria, Ohio, with an SD-40-2 was being served with an RS-5T, giving us a good horn show then. Another train, this one is a westbound on the Fostoria District, with a Unipacific Power, is leading the manifest on the Fostoria District. Thank you. I-150 going up to Detroit, Michigan from North Baltimore with Norfolk Southern AC4466M 4012 and a BNSF Gevo. I can't get the number of that unit. Empty coal train was flying south through Fostoria, Ohio on the Pemberville substation. I don't know what line it would be going on now. Now we're at the CNO Diamond at Fostoria. This is actually my first time being at CNO Diamond. Well, our first train is a coal train that was heading westbound on the Garrett subdivision. What a wonderful P5 on this eastbound manifest on the Fostoria District. Well, this will be the first NS I would see on the CNO Diamond, or BNO. I don't know what diamond it is in Fostoria. Let me know down in the comments below. But anyway, this is our first eastbound at the BNO or CNO Diamond. Westbound Intermodal on the weather subdivision. I don't, there will be a mid-DPU on this Intermodal, and then not too long after. M560 was heading eastbound on the Weber subdivision. While we were at the Diamond again, this is the shot that we got at the Diamond with M560 and this westbound in the morning. A CSX Intermodal heading westbound on the Willow subdivision is just Gevo's. 568, heading southbound and then going eastbound, going onto the Willard subdivision with a 1-2 gas is well in second. We'll be right back. train at Fostoria, Ohio will be a NX. On the Fostoria District, heading eastbound, is a manifest. We'll be right back.
no speak English. Me no speak English. No jiva. No jiva. Me no speak English. English, me no speak. Me lu telephone. Me lu telephone.
I'm blinding the viewer.
Me no speak English. Me no speak English. Me no like jiva. Me no like ji.
It was a dark and stormy night. The CSX Jivos were roaming the systems.
This very, 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 very good day would end us all at Poplar Street and this train. I would thought we would see more trains because we were sitting at this one spot across the street of Poplar Street from the whale park. I would thought we would see more trains on the Whaler Sub or the Fostoria District, but everything was red. But we ended up staying there after 30 minutes before we had to go back home after like a 12 or 11 or 13 hour day of well-fitting. Thanks for watching. I will see you guys in the Michigander State or the Buckeye State Whale.
What's going on?